Hey, what's up guys? Ace is here, and in today's video what we're going to do is we're going to talk about how to start affiliate marketing. So this video, chances are if you're watching it, it's because you're just getting started with affiliate marketing or you're thinking about getting started with affiliate marketing. And so this video is really going to be broken down to three different components in terms of helping you kind of start from scratch, basically from ground zero, and build your way up to actually building an affiliate marketing business. So the three sections I want to talk about with you guys here in this video start with, first off, picking the right product for you in your business so that you are making the most amount of money and in the financial way that you want to, in the different ways that you can actually get paid when it comes to affiliate marketing. Two, I'm going to be talking about the different types of tools you're going to need to actually start building up your affiliate marketing business. And lastly, we're going to be talking about picking the right traffic source for you in your business so that way you're able to go ahead and start making some sales. So now, with all those things being said, guys, if this is the first time you're kind of tuning into the channel, I really would appreciate that if you find value in this video, go ahead and give the video a like, as well as you can feel free to subscribe to this channel, as I'll be adding a lot more content just like this, you know, in the near future, and hopefully it'll help you out getting one step closer to actually making your affiliate marketing business grow. So with all that being said, let's get started. Okay, so let's first start talking about the product and picking the right product for you. So before I can really start talking about the product, what I want to do is I kind of want to quickly go over the affiliate marketing business model so you guys know exactly how it kind of works and how it is that you can actually get paid. All right, so basically when it comes down to the bare bones of it, guys, affiliate marketing is really, really simple in terms of the business model. Essentially, everything starts here with a product. Okay, so this little box here is a product. Okay, then what's gonna happen is that for your job as an affiliate, basically you're over here, right, as the affiliate, so you're nice and happy because you're looking to make some money, right, online, right? So you as an affiliate, your job is basically to promote this product, okay? And as you go about promoting this product, and we'll talk about promoting the product a little bit later, basically what happens is that as you continue to promote this product, you're hopefully gonna make some sales, right? Some people are gonna get interested in whatever, you know, you're interested in selling, whatever your product is, right? Hopefully you'll start making some sales. And for every time you make a sale of this particular product, what's gonna happen is that the company is going to pay you a commission for helping them sell this product. So think of it almost like a digital salesperson. Okay, so now let's really start talking about the different types of products you can actually sell. So when it comes to the different types of products you can actually sell, guys, you have two main options. You have physical products and you're going to have digital products. Now, I'm going to explain to you guys a little bit of the difference between the two and also the different types of levels of commission you can actually make. So when it comes to physical products, guys, probably the most common and the most obvious one that you can kind of think, that I can think of, is Amazon Associates. So obviously Amazon, we all know Amazon, you know, it's obviously a gigantic website with millions of products on there, and they actually have an affiliate marketing program called Amazon Associates. So the idea is really, really simple. Basically what happens is that you sign up as a Amazon Associate and you're able to promote different products that Amazon has on their website to, you know, your audience or to whomever you want to, right? So basically what'll happen is you get assigned a specific, you know, affiliate link, and every time you share that link around and somebody ends up clicking it and buying whatever product you're promoting, so say, let's say for example that product was a digital camera as an example, right? Anytime somebody clicks on that link and ends up buying that digital camera from you, you will make a commission. Okay, but because, you know, we're talking about physical products can be kind of expensive, first off, to make. Secondly, you're gonna have to warehouse these products, meaning they have to be held somewhere in the meantime in Amazon's warehouse, right? You're gonna have to worry about shipping and doing all that stuff. And so to literally manufacture, warehouse, and ship these products costs a lot of money, right? Because you're talking about a physical product you actually have to, you know, hold and make. And so because of that, you know, Amazon is taking on the brunt of that expense, right? So you personally as an associate, you're not, you know, worrying about all that stuff. All you're doing is promoting it and hopefully helping them sell it. So because of that though, because Amazon has such a high overhead of you know, having to hold these products, having to buy these products, and having to ship these products, basically what's going to happen is that your commission level is usually going to be a little bit lower. So that's kind of one of the fallbacks of physical products. A lot of the time your markup is going to be low. So meaning that your commission level is also going to be low. So I think for Amazon Associates specifically, I think it's somewhere between 8 and 12% for any product that you actually sell. Now this may be a little bit different when it comes to physical products if you are the one actually going out there and getting the products manufactured. Like say if you you know, outsource them to China or something like that, and you bring them back and you warehouse them yourself, like in your garage or something, and then you're shipping them out yourself. Obviously, you can do things that way as well, but that will take a lot more work, right? Because you literally have to go there, you have to invest your own money into a product that you're not even sure if you're gonna sell, and then you're gonna have to hold it in your garage. And the last thing you want is to end up with like 1,000 screen protectors or 1,000 phone cases or something that don't end up selling on Amazon. All right, guys. So something to kind of consider, right? That usually the markup for a lot of these physical types of products are going to be a little bit lower. So now let's move into something more like digital products. So digital products is probably my favorite way of promoting affiliate products, right? So digital products, just to give you an example, could be things like courses, right? So there's digital courses that people create that you can go ahead and help promote. You can have things like software, right, that you can actually promote as well. You can have things like coaching. So coaching can be a digital asset as well. So all these things can basically be piled into a digital product. Now, the cool thing with digital products, guys, is that basically there's not really any overhead when it comes to it, not like a physical product that you have to literally have manufactured, you have to store and all that stuff like we talked about earlier. With a digital product, right, it's a lot easier, right? Once the product is actually created, all it really took is time, right? It took the product creator, whether it's yourself or whether it's somebody else that you're leveraging, you know, it took their time to actually put this course together and piece it together and you know, basically get it all set up. But once the product is actually created, after that, there isn't really any overhead, right? It's literally just sitting on someone's hard drive, and then basically they're just going to distribute that, right? And so you're basically helping them do that, exactly, right? So the cool thing with information, though, as well, because digital products are mainly mostly information products, like courses or coaching. In other cases, there might be something that somebody needs access to, like a piece of software that's going to help them do a specific task, right? And in all these cases, guys, a lot of these things are usually pretty high end, meaning that for courses, you're usually going to be selling something that's maybe like $1,000. You could have obviously courses that are cheaper, maybe just a couple $100 or $500, right? But a lot of the times, like the higher end courses that you can focus on will sell for $1,000, $2,000. If you're doing things like coaching, it might be like $5,000, $10,000 packages. So that means that your commission, right, is going to be a lot higher because you're selling a much higher level product, right? So those are also known as kind of like high ticket affiliate programs, okay? So you can tend to make a little bit more money that way. So in both of these examples that I'm sharing with you guys, we're talking about just pretty much a straight exchange. So I want you guys to really understand this concept because it's something that a lot of people don't think about when it comes to affiliate marketing. In a simple, in a really basic sense, right, if every time you sell a product, right, and you make a sale, you make a commission. This is basically the physical and that digital example that I just talked to you guys about in terms of like a course or something like that. However, there are affiliate marketing programs, guys, that are usually more geared towards things like software, all right, where you can actually start building a recurring income. And this is definitely something that I think is probably a little bit more of an interest to a lot of people who are maybe just getting started, right? And it's the idea of creating passive income, creating recurring income. So there are a ton of softwares out there, guys, that basically with the way that they do is they are a monthly subscription. So when you get people to basically enroll in these monthly subscription types of software, what happens is that the companies will be willing to pay you a monthly commission as opposed to just like a one-time commission for the, you know, for as long as that person stays a member with their software or with their program or whatever it is. Membership sites kind of work the same way as well. So when you do that, guys, maybe you're not going to make a huge commission on the upfront, right? Maybe not, you don't want to make, you know, $100, you know, right from out of the gate, or $500 if you're selling like a course or something like that. But what you can do is you'll start making maybe like $10 a month from one person, right? And so if you think of it that way, if you're even making $10 a month from one person and you multiply that, let's say, by 100 people, well, guess what? Now you're going to start making $100, right? You're going to start making $100 a month from all these subscriptions, right? And the more members you have, the more money you can make. The great thing about recurring income, guys, is that you're going to start making you know, a more predictable income. It's income that's going to be continuously be coming in, and you're not going to have to worry about having to sell, you know, new products to new people every single month like you would with the other two examples that I shared with you. All right, so those are different things you want to definitely keep in mind. And depending on what your financial goal is, if your financial goal is just to hit to a certain level so that you can kind of maybe quit your full-time job so you can focus on your online, you know, career, you know, full-time, then maybe something with a recurring income might make more sense for you. Or if you want to just, you know, make like one-off bigger sales, and maybe focusing on a digital product might make more sense for you. Or if you want to kind of play it safe, not have to worry about an overhead and not do it all too much, and you're okay with just making smaller commissions, then maybe using something like a physical product might make the most sense for you. So you got to figure that out, guys, kind of balance that out. But now, like, hopefully you understand the different types of products and the different ways you can get paid when it comes to affiliate marketing. Okay, guys, so now that we've covered covered the products and the different ways you can get paid with affiliate marketing. Now I want to talk to you guys about the different tools you're actually going to need to start putting kind of things together. All right, guys, so there's going to be sections in this section of the video that will require me to go into a little bit more detail. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to leave a couple links for you guys in the description where you guys can get access to some more resources that I put together for you in terms of, you know, more of the how-tos and how to kind of put this stuff together. This video is definitely more about the bird's eye view and giving you guys an understanding of why you need some of these things to even begin with. So the first thing that I want to talk to you guys about is creating a website. So when it comes to creating a website, guys, a lot of people might tell you that you don't even need a website to start making sales. And I partially agree with them. So for you to maybe make your first initial sales, you may not necessarily need a website. However, if you're thinking about building a long-term business, if you're thinking about building a business that you want to scale up in the future, if you're thinking about a business that is going to hopefully last for years, then you're going to want to build a website, guys. And the reason why I say this, guys, is because the best way for you to build your affiliate marketing business is by branding yourselves. One of the biggest mistakes that I see a lot of, you know, newbie affiliates make is that they focus their business strictly on branding and building the name of the product or service that they're actually selling, as opposed to building a brand for themselves and becoming that trusted advisor that leads people to the products or the services that they actually need. So that those are two completely different ways of approaching your business. A lot of people who make okay money, maybe from the upfront and making a few commissions, focus on just the product or the service, right? And don't brand themselves at all. Those are the people that will tell you that you don't need a website. But think of things this way. You know, let's say a few years down the road, maybe the product or the service that you're selling disappears. I've seen this happen all the time online where a company goes under for whatever reason. Maybe they end up running out of money, or maybe they get bought out by a different company, or something may happen that may, you know, basically sees that company from existing. If that happens and you've been focusing all your energy on creating your affiliate business around promoting that product, well, guess what? If that product disappears, now you don't have a business anymore and you're gonna have to start all the way from ground zero again. And you don't wanna be in that position. So what you wanna do, guys, is you wanna focus on building yourself up as a brand, and instead you are suggesting or you are recommending different products and services to people, right? Because if you do things that way, then the stuff that you create, the content you create, which we'll talk about in a little minute, right, and all that stuff will never, you know, be redundant, right? It's stuff that you can always leverage, right? And so the products that you suggest can change, right? Just as your business changes. And so that way you're going to be able to build a long-term business that you're going to be able to scale up. And that's why branding is such a huge thing. And so your website, guys, basically allows you to do exactly that, right? It allows you to go ahead and actually brand yourself as an authority, right? You're able to brand yourself as an authority, you're able to brand yourself as a leader in your niche, right? And you're able to kind of build up from there, right? And so your website is almost like your home, right? This is kind of like where people can go to connect with you. They can go there to find out a little bit more about what you're up to, and all that stuff, right? So a website is going to help you definitely brand yourself. So if you're going to be building a website, guys, what you're going to need is you're going to need a few different things. The first thing is you're going to need a domain. So a domain is basically known as your website, right? So think of like my website, netplaymarketing.com, right? That is my domain. So you're going to need to find a domain first. You're gonna have to buy that. Then the next thing you're gonna have to do, guys, is get hosting. So hosting is basically where your website is saved on the internet. So think of it like this. When you create a website, guys, you need to be able to save your website on a hard drive on the internet somewhere, right? Because that's the way that people are able to access your website 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year. And so it's a required thing. And so hosting basically allows you to do exactly that. So that's basically what you're doing. You're paying to basically have your website saved on a server somewhere on the internet. Now, I'm going to leave a link to a couple links in the description, guys, so you guys can figure out, you know, exactly how to set up your domain, how to set up hosting, and how to basically get the basics of your website kind of created. And I'll leave a few resources for you guys in the description. But the main idea, guys, is that you really need to have these things kind of in place for you to kind of get your website going. All right. So once you've actually got a website going, guys, the next thing that you're going to want to leverage is then a sales funnel. So to create a sales funnel, guys, and you may have heard this before, right? On a very, very basic level, a sales funnel is basically going to consist of a landing page. So it's a one-page website. I'm going to draw it out here that usually asks people for their name and email, right? I'm sure you've probably come across pages like this, right? So this is called a landing page. The whole idea of this landing page is to be able to collect people's emails and add them to your email list. So the reason why you would want this, guys, is because you want to be able to reach out to people and be able to communicate to them about more information that maybe you want to educate them on, Maybe if you want to try and sell them different products later down the road, or whatever the case is, right? This is kind of what you want to do. So you're going to have, you need something to be able to create these landing pages. The next step is usually a thank you page, right? So I'm going to say a thank you page, TY, right? And then after this, usually what happens is you're going to send them to your email list, okay? So once you have people on your email list, the way that you're going to be able to communicate with them in the future, AKA send them future emails, right? And I'm sure you guys are probably part of different people's email lists already, right? Is, you know, times, let's say 100, 100 different emails that you might send them, right? For you to be able to communicate with them through your email list, you will need a tool called a autoresponder. So an autoresponder, guys, is basically a program that's gonna be linked to your email list. And so every time somebody submits their email, it's gonna be sent to this autoresponder. That's where it's gonna be saved. And inside of your autoresponder is where you're gonna be able to send out mass emails to, you know, hundreds of people at a time. You can't do this through your own personal email. You can't have people just sign up and you add them to an email list on your Gmail account, because your Gmail account eventually will flag you and say, hey, you can't send this many emails out in a day. So you can't do it that way. You need an autoresponder to be able to kind of build up your email list, okay? And the tool that you're going to need, guys, for, building the actual sales funnel component of this is usually called like a lead page builder. And so these guys is, I'll give you guys a few examples of both of these types of softwares. So one, we'll talk about the lead page builder. So there are tons out there that you can definitely leverage. There's literally one called Lead Pages, okay? They're one of the original ones that kind of started up. There are ones like ClickFunnels, which is the one that I personally use and I love. And then there are definitely others. There's like things like Builderall. There's Instapages or Instapage. I can't remember if it's exactly which one it is. Instapage or Instapages. I can't remember. So these are all examples of different softwares you can use to build landing pages and stuff like that. When it comes to your autoresponder, for you to be able to control your email list, guys, there's ones that you can start off like AWeber. That's the one I started with. There's things like ConvertKit. And I'm gonna actually add ClickFunnels into here because it's the one that I actually personally use. And what I like about ClickFunnels is because it's just one-stop shop. I have literally all my landing page builders. I can create websites and everything with ClickFunnels on that side, as well as I can manage my autoresponder, all my emails, all from one spot. So I don't have to log into multiple softwares. But the thing is, ClickFunnels might not be the cheapest option for you. So you may have to get some. If you're on a budget and you're just trying to get started with the low end, then you can look into some of these other options as well, guys, because it will be a little bit cheaper, maybe overall. So. Once you've actually built these two things, guys, now what you're able to do is you're able to create what's called a sales funnel, right? And the whole point of building a sales funnel is that it helps to basically educate your potential customers and your potential clients into wanting to purchase the product that you're trying to promote, right? And so it kind of takes them through a sales journey, essentially. That's basically what you're trying to do. And so I'm going to leave a link in the description as well, guys, where I actually go into a lot more detail in terms of how to build an appropriate affiliate marketing funnel and why it's so important to your business and how it's going to help you basically create passive income and be able to really allow you to scale up your business to whatever level you want to and really start creating the type of income you want to from your affiliate marketing business. Okay, guys, so now let's talk about traffic. So what I want to do before I try to kind of jump into this is I want to hopefully demystify and clarify some of the misconceptions that are out there about traffic. You know, this is something that I struggled with for a very, very long time when I first got started with my affiliate marketing business. And it's because I think I had this misconception or this idea that there was going to be one magic traffic source that was going to help me make sales, you know, every single day. And I used to watch these super affiliates and these gurus that were, you know, just killing it and crushing it in my business, and I would see them like talking about doing things like paid traffic and doing all this other stuff, right? And I would try to do exactly what they were doing, but I didn't fully understand exactly what was happening. And so what happened was I ended up spending literally thousands and thousands of dollars on paid traffic and other things, and I got pretty much no results for it. And so I don't want the same thing to happen to you. And so what I really want you to really understand here, guys, is that traffic is literally everywhere. Okay, there isn't a magic traffic source for you. It's the traffic source that's going to make the most sense for you is one that you have to pick and that you're comfortable with, you know, doing. And the whole point of traffic, guys, is not to sell people on your first experience with them. And that's a huge misconception people have. A lot of people think that if they just get somebody who's semi-interested in something, they send them to a sales page, that they're going to make a sale. And that pretty much happens never. Okay, there's probably like somewhere like less than 5% of people who are going to buy a product or a service from you at their first experience or their first exposure to your product, no matter how amazing your product is. Okay, guys, and so what you need to do, guys, is you need to have an actual sales funnel in place for you to be able to help guide people through a sales journey that's going to take them from interested to a little bit more interested to really interested to ready to buy. Okay, and that's kind of the magic of a sales funnel. And so I've left a link for you guys in the description where I actually take you through this whole process. But I want to kind of just talk about traffic here for a quick minute, guys, because it is this probably the most important part of your whole business model, to be honest with you. And it's the part that I feel a lot of people don't really talk about. So when it comes to traffic, guys, there are a ton of traffic sources out there that you can leverage even organically. You don't even need to talk about paid traffic just yet, right? You can start by just literally doing things organically. So there's going to be things like YouTube. I mean, there's a reason why I'm on YouTube, guys. This isn't by accident. This isn't an accident that I'm here, you know, creating these videos for you. YouTube is an amazing resource for people who are wanting to learn about a specific product. They're trying to learn about maybe how to make money online, kind of like I'm sharing with you guys right now. They're trying to learn whatever product or service you're trying to sell, they're trying to learn about on things like YouTube. And so if you're creating content that, you know, answers questions they might have about your product, answers questions about how to get started with it, answers questions about, you know, how they can see success with whatever product or service you're trying to sell, then you're getting them one step closer to making a buying decision. And because you were the person that helped them, gets you one step closer to making a sale. Okay, think of it that way. So the next thing, guys, is Facebook. Facebook is a huge place that you can get people from. Now, I wouldn't say that you'd want to kind of go on Facebook and start blasting stuff all over your Facebook feed, right? Because we've seen people who do that, right? They just have affiliate links blasted all over the place, right? And that just really comes off as desperate, right? That's not what we want to do. What we want to do is we want to go into things where people are engaged and talking about specific topics or specific, you know, things that make sense to your product or service that you're trying to sell. So a great place to do that, guys, would be inside of Facebook groups. What'll happen is if you go in there and you become part of the community, you start answering questions for people, you help people understand the industry or the product or the service and answer some of those questions, what's going to happen is they're naturally going to see you as a leader. They're going to see you as somebody who knows what they're talking about, and they're going to add you on Facebook. They're going to friend you, request you. They might send you messages on Facebook, and then what you're going to do is you're going to be able to lead them to whatever product or service you might be selling, right? Simply by having conversations with them, right? And as they add you as friends on Facebook, what you can then do is you can leverage your Facebook feed by doing things like Facebook Live, or maybe you're educating people on specific topics that make sense and answer questions that maybe you've commonly been answering inside of those Facebook groups, right? That's why you can leverage both of those things to start creating quality content people are going to actually want, which is actually going to lead them to buying stuff from you. Another great resource, guys, is Instagram. Especially now with the introduction of Instagram stories and Instagram TV, you're able to create content, right? Longer term content that will hopefully educate people, similar to that of your Facebook Lives or YouTube channel, right? And so you're able to do stuff like that. As well as Instagram kind of, the platform lends itself to being kind of like the behind the scenes look of what you're doing. So if you're building, let's say, an affiliate marketing business, you can easily jump on Instagram and show people, hey guys, today I'm creating a video on this topic because, you know, I had a few people reach out to me, about this specific, with these specific questions. So I figured, you know what, creating a YouTube video about this topic would be really, really cool, but I wanted to give you guys a sneak peek, so keep yourself on the lookout for my next YouTube video because I'll be going into this, and I'm going to be sharing with you guys this. So do you see how like Instagram lends itself to kind of doing that? People are like, people want to see the behind the scenes of the people that they follow, people that they respect, and people that they like, right? And so if you're using and leveraging Instagram the right way, you can lead people to your YouTube channel, you can lead people to your Facebook page, and maybe you're going to do a Facebook Live or whatever the case is. It's a great way to give people a behind the sneaks peek of what you have coming up next on your other bigger channels, all right? And another great way, guys, still exists is blogs. A lot of people will tell you that blogging is dead, but you know what? Blogging still has, you know, there's tons of bloggers out there that are still making literally tens of thousands of dollars off of their blog every single day. And the concept is really, really simple, right, guys? People are gonna go into Google every single day and, you know, Google questions that they have about specific topics, right? Like how to make money online, or how can I cook a proper steak? Whatever topic you're talking about, guys, people are searching for it on Google, I guarantee you, right? And if you're creating content to answer some of the questions that they're looking for, then guess what? You can start creating a blog around your topic, around your product, and around your service. And all you're gonna do is you're gonna be recommending that service or product to that person. So in a simple example, kind of like I just shared with you, somebody's maybe looking at, you know, how can I create the perfect steak at home, right? Maybe you have a food blog, and in your food blog you say, hey, the top three ways of making steak at home, right? Or the top 10 steaks that you should buy for for making the perfect steak at home, or whatever the case is, right? I don't know. I'm not a cook, guys. But you basically start creating content like that, and people might, you know, land on your blog, and then they see that you have a ton of other recipes and a ton of other tips and stuff like that. Maybe you have a free giveaway there where you're going to share, you know, where you share people, you know, your top 10 recipes for making quick meals at home, something simple like that. Then they're going to maybe download that product, or maybe they won't want to buy it if it's something you're selling for maybe like 10 bucks, right? And then you can start making money by literally doing that, right? Do you see the power of this, guys? That whole process I just shared with you is a sales funnel, right? And so that's why I said you want to have a home like creating a website. You want to be able to leverage that, right? You want to create content like you are doing, right? By creating a traffic source like YouTube or Facebook or Instagram or blogging, right? So that's going to be your resource or your traffic source that you're going to use to send people to these websites, right? So the whole point of traffic, guys, so just to kind of summarize here, is that we are going to basically be funneling these people from this content by creating content that's very specific, answering their questions and the needs that they need, right, into your sales funnel. Okay, so again, guys, I really hope this video was helpful in helping you understand a little bit more about how to start your affiliate marketing journey. And I've left a few links for you guys in the descriptions in terms of a little bit more details in terms of some of the how-to stuff and the more detail-oriented stuff in terms of how to create a proper sales funnel for your affiliate marketing business. I've left a link for you guys there in the description, as well as if you're looking in terms of some of the website building tactics and stuff like that as well that you're going to need. I've sent a walkthrough for you guys there in the link down below. So hopefully this video was really, really helpful. I really hope it was, and I look forward to seeing you guys in the next video. Take care.